LOL. I'm so excited for you. I just found out that they are going to let me go, but I was planning on leaving anyways. But I'm happy that you are still there and that you got promoted so quickly. We have to celebrate soon. XOXO. Did you wanna? Oh, so I'm gonna be drinking alone. Well, that was your little friend just texting me about how she got her promotion at work, the job that I just got let go from. No, I think she wants me to like go out and celebrate with her. I don't know. I'm just probably gonna come up with some type of excuse. Do you understand? And I know I'm about to like go out on an entire rant right now, but do you know? She had the nerve the other day. I did her makeup, dressed her up real nice, had her looking all cute. And in the midst of me doing her makeup, you know the guy that I used to like? Yes, him. So, I'm doing her makeup. Mind you, I told her that I kinda liked him a few months ago, okay? But longer than a few months ago, like over a year ago is the first time I mentioned it. Then I mentioned it again like a few months ago, right? So, I'm doing her makeup or whatever, and all of a sudden, I ask, is the person gonna meet that I like? And she said, yeah, and we're dating. And I'm just like, okay, honey, so were you gonna mention this, or did you plan on me coming and, like, just having me look crazy? Because I just don't. What do you think she did for the promotion? The promotion. Look, I'm not even intoxicated, so I can't even talk. I think I'm just like over it. And she keeps texting me. And that's another thing. If you're at work, do your job. Like, why do you keep texting me? Let's go for drinks later. Off at 7. Of course, I'm already having a drink for you right now because I'm so excited. So, how much more work do you have now? Anyways, this is your friend. I remember when you told me she did the same thing to you. It's like a thing of her. Honestly, she ain't shit, okay? I'm just gonna say it. I always try to be so nice because I'm the golden child. I have a heart of gold. I try to see the best in people, but you know what? After this, and I kind of feel like she's the reason that I got fired now that I'm thinking about it. I got her the job, right? Okay, so I've been working up there, like I said, for about 5 years. All of a sudden, she gets laid off, and we were just talking about just how much money she made last week, and I'm just like, okay, so they pay you that much to sit at the desk now. Granted, that's a lot for her, right? So I guess it's a lot for her. Like, I was making more. I made more anyways in the past. At the current time, I wasn't making as much, and they just let me go. But she asked me, could I give her the hookup with the manager or whatever? I'm like, of course, you know, whatever. You know, come to the plug. Come to your friend. I am your friend. So, yeah, let me help you. Let me help save you from your situation since you make so much money. So, give her the manager's number. Her and the manager are talking for, I just feel like, longer than what it should be for a manager. Like, all I'm saying is after 9 o'clock, you should not be trying to call and talk to the manager about a job, okay? So anyway, she tells me the next day how she talked to him for so long on the phone. Next thing you know, I see her show up at work. She didn't even tell me when she was going to start. So I'm working at my desk. All of a sudden, I just hear Mook, Mook. I'm like, hey. I'm just like, basically, what are you doing here? And then, so she told me that she got the job. Now, you don't just come in my position, okay? My position is very, like, up there. I'm, like, right underneath the CEO. I should basically own the damn company, really. And so they put her at a desk right next to mine. So I'm just like, what exactly did y'all talk about on the phone? That you didn't have to come in here and work 5 years and it's just handed to you on a silver platter? Now, I like the girl, okay? I like her. I think she's cool for what cool might be. She can be fun sometimes. Well, my entire thing is I'm the queen, okay? You need to know your place. You need to know who the queen is. At the end of the day, you need to be thanking me. How do I get fired? How do I get fired? All of a sudden, you're here and I get fired? Like, are you trying to push me out the picture? Do you want to be me? Now I'm sitting here with a bottle of wine. You're talking about let's go celebrate. Honey, I just gotta let go, okay? But that's okay, because I have so much money saved up and I'm in high demand, okay? My resume runs long, honey. So just because I got you this little job, which will not happen again, because I don't think it's a coincidence that I just got let go when I just laid out the carpet for you to get this job. My resume is so good. I don't even care. And when I'm filthy rich, and I see my manager still working at the same job. I just want to know how she got the position. How do you think? Just give me some ideas. Don't be shady, you know. Just say what you feel. How do you think she got the position? And I want to know details. All the details in your nasty little mind. You worse than me, okay? You way worse than me. I just thought maybe she sweet talked or whatever. You, that's what we're friends. Are you sure you don't wanna? Are you sure you don't wanna drink? It's 11%, honey. None of that 3% Moscato. You gonna get a little drunk today? Are you serious? The sweet wine, duh. Whatever. Are you gonna come out with us tonight or what? Because. And she keeps texting me. Hold on. Wait. Okay, so now she's saying that the actual manager that hired her and fired me wants to come along, that he wants to see me. Wait, how should I respond to this? Like, should I just go off? Because I feel like I'm suppressing, you know? I've been holding a lot lately. Should I just go off? Like, why would I want my manager who just fired me? Or should I just be like, yeah, just bring him along. Like, he was cool while I was there before he fired me and before you took my position in my entire life and my husband or whatever. Like, should I tell me what I should do? I'm really trying to just stay calm. So, I played it cool. I said he can come. Because I kind of want to see how they interact together, to be honest. talk about me when I'm a, like I'm a dog when we're not together. Because I'm starting to kind of think you're a fake friend because I didn't even know you had all these feelings towards her. Now, you knew it was a little bit of animosity between me and her. But this is kind of surprising coming from you. But I like it. I can't lie. She said, yay. See you at 7. I'm so excited. Oh my god. Let me find something to put on. I'm gonna get dressed up, but it's just still baffling to me. And then even when we went out the other day, I just felt like she was kind of like all over him more. Even whenever, like I say, I want to go to the bar or something, he would be at the bar already, and then she'd be like, oh no, I'll come with. Okay, come with. I'll go to the bathroom. I come back. She's sitting in a seat that I was sitting in that's like closer to him. I'm just like, I don't know. It was just weird to me. And then every single time we were like in the car and talking because we were Ubering everywhere. So every single time we were in the car and Uber and he would like say something to me, she would start like speaking for me. So I'm just like, and I just feel like it's just me because I know I'm so fabulous and I just can't help that. But it's at the same time, like I said, you need to know your place. Now this is her. No, I mean, they look happy together, and that's great, but all I'm gonna say is that I feel like he still likes me, and I feel like there was times when he was flirting with me, but I just let it go, you know, because it's like, well, you made your choice. You must not have good taste in women because look what you chose. No offense, she's a nice girl, but I'm just saying. So, the question is, are you coming out with us tonight? Because if I'm gonna get inebriated or a little tipsy, I'm gonna definitely need some backup because I just don't know if I can stomach the thoughts of. Let me take it back, because while you're talking about some no, it's not an option, honey. You're coming. Like, you're already here. I have some clothes that you can throw on. I have to change, and then we're gonna go. Because it's already what, 5:47, so we got about an hour and 13. I'm gonna ask her why she keeps texting at work, because I wasn't even allowed to really be on my phone. I had my own desk, my own office, everything, and they just came and set her right next to me. It's like, let me ask her, what are you doing now? Because I just want to know. And also, well, I guess that would be kind of tacky to text my manager after he, like, fired me. But it's also tacky that he wants to come out and, like, kick it like we're supposed to be friends now. Okay, whatever. You know, I'm a shady queen. I don't like to think that I'm dramatic. But what I can say is that I handle myself well. And this is a game they want to play. It's okay. Because like I said, my resume runs really long. I have job opportunities all over the place. I could really start my own business if I wanted to. I just really need a secretary of my own. Matter of fact, that's what I'll do tonight after we come back. I'll start looking for me a secretary so they can put everything in line, put me together a business plan. Because I just feel like I don't need to do the menial task in life. And somebody should do them for me. I should just be like the person that does it, does the actual plan. Somebody just needs to write it out for me just because I'm that person. And it's okay. I don't even need the job. It's okay. She can have the little job. I deserve better anyways. And if she wants to settle for a job like that, that's just all up to her. But what I do know, when I get my next job and she asks me about it, I'm just going to tell her how much more I make. And I'm going to tell her to also tell the manager how much more I make. And She said she's on her 15-minute break. See, that's what I'm saying. I don't know what she did to get in my position. You have to really be skilled. You have to have a degree. She doesn't even have, I mean, she has an associate's degree, for crying out loud. I have my PhD. I'm just saying. No, associate's degrees are still good, okay? And you know what I mean. Because you felt the same way when something similar happened, when she did the same thing to you. That's what I'm saying. So she's on a 15-minute break, an hour before her shift is over. I'm just trying to think of how she got this job, honey. But you know what? That's none of my business. Maybe it's God's plan. Maybe it's God's plan that she just go around doing stuff like that. But what I can say is that there's a place after you leave this earth that is strictly for you, since you want to do people like this. Since you want to take people's men and stuff. So, we'll go meet her at 7. Are you excited? Because I'm excited to go out. I need to go out. No, it'll be fun. It'll be fun. You know, like I said, I like some things louder and whatever. And I kind of do want to see what the manager is out, like, outside of work or whatever. So, I'm a little excited, but don't be too shady, because you know I can hide in, honey. So, I know sometimes you just be coming out the woodwork for what you want to say. Now, I just thought I was about to start getting ready. I told her you were coming too. And she said she's so excited to see you. Stop. Come on, let's get ready to go. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and put my stuff on. I guess we're going to meet at the bar that we normally meet at. So, you did not hear from me, okay? You didn't hear any of this from me. I'm fine. I'm cool. I'm good with all of it. Like I said, I'm the queen, and everybody already knows that. So, I'm not mad. I'm just ready to go have a good time with my friends. So, let's get out of here.